I'm back with another video. This one is how to do a braided ponytail. I'm excited as fuck. Okay, so we're gonna start with braiding hair. This is all the materials you're gonna need for this style. Gonna need some jam, and then we're gonna need some spritz and some hair glue. You also want like a comb as well. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take the hair, unravel that braid off of the pack of hair. We're gonna make sure you keep the rubber band that's already in there. If you wanna add hair or take out hair, you're free to do so. Just keep a rubber band in the middle of the braiding hair. So with that, we're gonna take one piece of hair and keep it in the back of your client, and then we're gonna ask your client to hold the other piece of hair. In the video, I'm basically showing you what I mean. So ask the client, just hold that right there. And what you wanna do, you wanna tie the rubber band underneath the rubber band that is already tied. So I am gonna zoom in so you can see it a little more, but you're gonna wrap it around the original ponytail three times. Try and get it as close to the back of that rubber band that you can, and just like really secure it so it doesn't go anywhere. I know you can kind of see it right there. Looks good and looks nice and neat. Take the hair back from the client and you're just gonna loop over the hair. You see how as I'm doing that, you can't see her natural hair anymore. It's thick enough and it's good enough that I can just start braiding, and it's gonna completely hide her natural hair. Feel free to make it as thin or as thick as you want. Now we're moving on to the band. Okay, so for the band, I like making the band no bigger than my finger. So if it's bigger than that, then it's gonna be way too thick. So this is what I use for reference. That's like a perfect band. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take some spritz and you're just gonna spritz it on that band. Get it nice and flat and sleek. You can also add some Gatsu spray or gel or whatever you feel comfortable with. This is what I like to do. And I just put a little bit of jam, just kind of comb it through. Just so it's nice and sleek and it doesn't look like the braiding hair. It looks nice and laid. So now I'm wrapping the band around the ponytail. You want to make sure that you get it nice and sleek. You see how I'm kind of making it extra tight? You don't gotta kill their head, but just make it nice and tight, you know? Now I'm gonna add some glue to that band so that the band doesn't unravel when it doesn't go anywhere and it's nice and tight as it dries. So I'm doing that, wrapping it around, and I'm not perfect. So I felt like it wasn't too good. So I was like, gotta do this over. So you can see me redoing the bands as I'm like trying to perfect it, because I'm a perfectionist and it takes some time. It takes practice, but the end result is worth it. So yeah, you're just wrapping that band around, making sure it's nice and sleek, adding that glue so that it doesn't go anywhere and it doesn't slip. That's like one of the most important parts. You see how I wrap it, but I felt like it wasn't what I wanted, so I kind of just like took it off and just kind of rewrapped it a little tighter just so I get that nice like sleek band so it looks like human hair. So as you wrap it, when you're getting to towards the end, you want to make sure to make it nice and tight and kind of tuck it into the ponytail. So as you can see, I'm kind of tucking it, and I end it by moving my nail and tucking it into the crevices of the ponytail. You can do that with a rat tail comb and then securing it with spritz and just putting a blow dryer to it on like medium high and just letting it dry up and really form that really nice band. Now we're moving on to the braid. It's braid time, girls. I'm excited. So we're separating it into three strands, and then I'm going to get my other braiding hair together and kind of split it into sections so that when I'm braiding, I can add the hair in like a feeding braid. So I usually put on a hair rack, but for this video, I just made Jolene hold it. So Jolene's holding my hair, and we're just gonna move along. Okay, so now I'm working on the three strands that I'm turning into the big braid. So I'm making sure to tuck her natural hair in, bring all that hair up on top so you don't see any of her natural hair. And then I'm going to add braiding hair as I go. You see how I did one loop? Now I'm gonna take some braiding hair from Jolene and kind of put it into my ponytail. The method that I use, I'm not sure if it's too common, but I just figured out what way worked for me adding braiding hair in. I learned all this stuff off of YouTube, so feel free to freaking YouTube your ass off and learn how to do this. I might put up a video of how to like braid, but I'm not too sure. I don't really care to do that. Anyways, let's move on. So I'm making sure to tuck in her natural hair. You see how I'm moving in the braiding hair so that you don't see her natural hair as I'm braiding, because her natural hair is kind of short. And then I'm adding hair as well, so that is nice and thick. I like adding hair as I go because it makes it nice and thick and it doesn't make it thinner as you keep going because you're still adding hair. And then I just add a little bit of jam. You don't want to OD because you don't want it to look like a super shiny ponytail. You still want it to look nice and like natural. And then I'm just braiding down and adding hair, braiding down, adding hair. I fast forward the video for the sake of time. So basically, I'm just ending the braid right now. The braid kind of cut off because I didn't realize I wasn't in the camera view when I was braiding this long-ass braid. But y'all get the point. Braiding down all the way to the ends. And then I am securing it with a tiny rubber band. The little rubber bands you get from the dollar stores from the Beauty Supplies are fine. Now I'm just going to spray it with some Sheen and get her ready. Sheen is just a good way of like making it like shiny and just look presentable for your Instagram pictures, and it just gives it a good finish. She's done. She's ready. Now y'all basically know how to do what I do. It takes practice, so don't think you're going to get this in one shot, but it's a super easy style. And if I can do it and I can show you guys how to do it, then I'm sure with practice and being locked in your houses, you're going to be fine and you're going to look popping. Bye. You guys can enjoy this last little clip of how it came out. Thanks for watching, everyone.